Let's take you back to Pietermaritzburg. Simpiwe Makhanya has got the Minister of Arts and Culture, Minister Nathi Mthethwa. Simpiwe, what's the minister saying this morning?
Thank you, Desiree. Well, certainly let us not waste time and engage the Minister of Sports, Arts and Culture, that Mr. Nathi Mthethwa. Nyambo, so thank you very much for your time and for joining us this morning. In terms of the importance of today, can the youth of South Africa look back at the youth of 1976 with pride and say we've achieved that that which the youth of 1976 fought for?
Well, not really, but a lot has happened, because remember that it wasn't only about protesting about Afrikaans as a medium of instruction, but it was also normalizing the political situation, which was abnormal and under colonialism of a special type. And therefore, that bridge has been crossed in 1994 through the 1994 breakthrough, but challenges still remains. But if you look back, for instance, the Balkanization of education, for instance, now you have one system of education in the country. You no longer have a 17 and so on. You have one system of education. There is a sense of a country moving forward to equal education. There's still a challenge on the access to education, but so much has been done. So many things have been put in place by a democratic government, but somewhat the challenges seem to be a bit different today, because as this year, the emphasis is more on youth unemployment. And it is more about social cohesion, transformed society. You'd recall what happened a few days ago in Witbank, for instance, which says that the road to this transformed society is still, you know, long ahead of us, whilst there's been strides which have been. So in other words, you have a mixed bag of what would have triggered the 1976 uprising to date in the country.
Minister, on the issue of education, you mentioned the issue of fees must fall and saying that government has done a lot in terms of addressing that inequality. But there's also a complaint which says that the governing party, which is the ANC, is not fulfilling its promise to young people to say those who want to access higher education can do so. Why is it taking so long for the government of South Africa to see to it that their dream is realized?
Well, I think that we just have to be objective about it and say that there was no NSFAS to talk about before 1994. You have NSFAS today. You have the majority of needy children, the students, being supported by government as we speak. You'll always have gaps, you'll always have challenges, but there's been a steely resolve and determination from the side of government to ensure that the doors of learning are open to all. And you can't say that prior 1994 and today nothing has happened. In fact, the fight is about the very resources which the government of the day has, given out to students out there. And I'm not in any way undermining the fact that from time to time the issue of adequacy of this support becomes an issue. But we're talking about something which is there, which is happening. And from the point of view of the department and the Minister of Higher Education, Science and Innovation, you have seen that we are steadfast as government. We want to ensure that everybody is catered for within this kind of a situation.
Minister, what do you say though to young people who may say, I've lost all hope since the democratic dispensation? I've lost all hope since the democratic dispensation. Nothing has changed in my life. Do you want them to look back on the youth of 1976 and reflect with pride?
You know, we are talking about a very special sector in our society, the youth, which in many cases has its own way of doing things. The young people have always been at the cutting edge of the revolution. They, from generation to generation, if you cast your eyes back to the generation of the 40s of the youth, to the 60s generation, to the 70s, to the 80s, even to the youth of 2000s, they will be able to take up issues which affect them. They would know to identify their challenges. All what is happening, which is different now, is that they have a society and a democratic government which is very much sensitive to their needs as opposed to the past. And when they say fees must fall, you have the government which is sympathetic and understand where they come from. There would never be a situation in any capitalist mode of production system where there is adequacy of anything and everything. The struggle is always continuous. And people will always, from different sectors, not only youth, there are issues about women, there are issues of discrimination, which are all within government and partnering with society and civil society to work towards a new society, a socially cohering nation, and build this nation. It's not an event. It will happen from time to time. Sometimes challenges change from this specific challenge to the other and so on. But all what we can say to the young people of this country is that they have the government which is hearing them, they have the government which is sensitive to their views, and they will always have support of the government of the day.
Minister, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much.
That's Minister Nathi Mthethwa. He is responsible for sports, arts and culture here in South Africa, saying, of course, that the struggle of the youth should continue. Back to you, Desiree, in Johannesburg and Zimkita.
Thank you so much, Simpiwe. And of course, after the minister, all we are awaiting now is an address from President Cyril Ramaphosa.